I mean, I'm going in my ninth year next year and I haven't won, so I'm just definitely motivated, and I'm just, yeah, it just sucks, you know, losing four in a row.
And now here comes Kane, moving in, he scores! Here's Newhart, the pass across, scores! Here comes McKinnon, moving in, he scores! Now Kulak turns the net, they score! The Avalanche come right back, there's puck, scores! Fogelman with a shot, Kemper couldn't find the puck, they score! Drives it across, shot, score! Back across for a try, they score! O'Connor slides it across, they score! Pulls the spring on McCarr, they score! There's Cassie in centering pass, score! There's Bryshotte across, score! Landeskog, empty net, score! Avalanche, 8-6.
Look at the crowd gather around. You'd think they were giving away signed Gretzky jerseys. Biz, bet Brian Whitney, you can see him right there. He bet him that the Flames would go further than the Oilers. Obviously, that's not the case.
I'm a little nervous. These guys are yelling in my grill, shave my head. I'm saying it's going to be a sweep. Keep talking trash. You shouldn't even advance to the second round. You shouldn't even advance to the second round. That golden goal should have counted. Oh, yeah, laugh it up. Laugh it up, all of you.
And
what's going on,
yeah,
boys?
The new look.
I'm ready to go.
Now
what do you got for us?
You look strong.
Thank you.
And in no way creepy at all.
All right.
Strong play by Jesse Puljujärvi. Comes out in front. What a straight top. Puljujärvi gets a second chance. Looks skyward after that miss.
This gets blocked off of McLeod. Goes right in front. And he had Francouz down. And quick little reaction stopping up. The rolling puck as he puts it up and over and just wide from in tight.
High, and that got past McKinnon down the ice and looking for Francouz. Charge out. Cody Ceci with Francouz way out of the net. Good play, but Francouz was able to recover. The fans will give him a cheer for that.
And he was caught in no man's land. Francouz, though, backing up instead of turning his head away, had his eyes on the puck the whole time and able to make the save.
That pass, Brandon gets it back. Kadri scores! They're announcing Kadri, but I think you're right. It looked like a lucky attempt. Johansson scores! And they double down in a hurry, 15 seconds apart.
Dad looks on, not a great feeling there as his son has put the Edmonton Oilers down by two, and Woodcroft says we can't continue to let this happen.
Here again is Nazem Kadri. Brandon loves it, gets it, scores! 3 goals in 2 minutes and 4 seconds, and it's 3-0 Avalanche.
Midway through the Colorado power play. Puck deflects off the stick of Smith. Out in front for Landeskog, and Smith able to get back and make the stop.
Old school hockey there. He stacked the pads to keep it out. A ton of early stops and a lot of them in a different ways. And that's a stacked pad stop there, Panger.
Nichushkin lifts the puck down along the wall. And that deflected off Nurse. They score!
Watch the stick of Nurse. He's trying to take the pass away and right there chips it and elevates it and Smith can't find it.
That is a momentum sapper certainly for Edmonton.
6 skaters on the ice for Edmonton. Here is Perry. Tees one up. And that's blocked by Lehkonen. McDavid back out. For a shot by Barry, another block by Lehkonen. The second Edmonton goal. Picked off by McCarr. Tried to shoot it out, and it hit off the helmet of Lehkonen, his teammate. He was going for the empty net.
Lehkonen laying out, not once, but twice. An outstanding job from a guy that's just getting the job done for the Avalanche.
And then he blocks McCarr's with his head, inadvertently.
There it is.
Can't help himself.
Here's Landeskog for Taves. Taves with a shot, score! Just 31 seconds in.
It was off the leg of Ceci, who's trying to keep McKinnon away from the doorstep.
Yeah, he is trying his best to box out. He's doing the right thing. An unfortunate break there and a great one for the Avalanche.
Avs control, held out for McCarr. Shot stop, rebound, Lehkonen scores! The Colorado Avalanche are headed to the Stanley Cup Final. Let's bring in Don Koharski. Koho, what did you see?
That has to be above the shoulder.
Oh.
Puck on the stick, above the shoulder. Holy shit. Oh, sorry.
Holy shit.
Just shucks, that's going to be, that's close.
You meant to say holy jumping, Packer.
He did. That's a holy jumping.
Yeah. Igor, you're here as one of the finalists for the Vezina as a top goaltender. Okay, the question I really want to ask you is, I've seen your headbands, and these are the headbands I used to wear when I was young. How does it, yeah, can we see it? How does it?
Cheap deal from Amazon.
How does it not hurt under your helmet?
Like, I have very good hair, and it doesn't matter for me. I don't feel it.
Shannon Chuck, when Jimmy Fallon was on the big screen showing some of the celebrities in the stands, and once he recognized that he was on the camera, puts on a show as usual, host of The Tonight Show, and chugs a beer for good measure.
Talking
Here's
about
Sean McEnroe right below him there.
Yeah, how expensive a ticket.
Yeah, he might have got some of that hot dog and beer game on Mac. He won't like that too much.
Fox puts it in the middle for Lafreniere. Back for Hino, and he scores again!
The Rangers have scored more on Tampa Bay tonight than Tampa Bay gave up in the last round.
That's a great point. Florida, in four games, scored three goals. The Rangers have four tonight.
Just another great shift in the offensive zone off the cycle.
Here come the Rangers! And Getzlaf's still looking for it. Corey Berry got there. Gaudreau was trying to whack at it. It stayed out. But what a sequence of events, and it was just chaos in front of the Lightning net.
And I don't know how he keeps this from going out. There's the hand that comes back right there by Corey Perry to deny it going over the line, and he somehow swallows it up.
Riley Nash down over Belmar. He put it right on. Long rebound out to Ruda. He wristed one wide. The horn went off, but that didn't go in. And everybody stops.
You can almost feel the confusion in here. The horn goes off. People are cheering. They're not even really sure what they're cheering because they know the puck didn't go into the net.
The call on the ice is no goal. We stopped the play because of the horn.
Well, that pretty well tells the story here.
Jack,
where the faceoff is.
Sorry, Raven, that expression said it all. Flicked in a little bit deeper by Reeves. Whoa, played back toward his own goal by Sergachev.
It's already a tough enough position with the other guy shooting on you.
Just wanted to make sure Vasilevskiy was still awake. He centers one out in front. Great chance for Kopp. He tried to pass to Strom.
He's got Strom and he wants to. Oh, it's a good play. I thought he was in a better shooting position. If Strom stops instead of sliding, it's in the net.
Cirelli. Schneider raced to keep it in. Nobody knew where the puck was. It was right at Cirelli's feet.
They don't realize the puck's right there. And now Tampa Bay coming up with it. It was Hagel.
What's on your tie?
It's a tiger, I guess.
It's a good looking tiger.
Yeah.
He likes tigers.
Yeah. I like cats. Yeah.
Same
thing. That's why we're good friends with Vasi.
Kelly Rudy said in our pregame show, Andre Vasilevskiy may be the only reason this series goes back to Tampa for a game six. And how about that focus ahead of this one here tonight? And a little extra oomph in swatting the puck off the dasher at the beginning of warm-ups. His mental strength once again put to the test here tonight. Steered aside all 10 shots in the early going.
Colorado's had two 2-on-1s tonight with their defensemen. This back in the first period, Josh Manson. Look where he shoots it from. Look where it goes. Blocker side and in. A few moments ago, same place, same shot, same delivery, same result. The shorthanded marker by Makar makes it 6-0.
I'm overall just play aggressive.
Will you celebrate it all tonight?
No.
Thanks, Cal.
Awesome, thank you.
And I believe him.
Let's show you earlier this morning while Maroon was working forehand, backhand. Kevin Bieksa was on camera too. Just fantastic work by Kevin.
What an easy
planning
job.
It with the rack focus.
Joined by Hall of Famer, former NBA MVP, but most importantly around these parts, good friend of John Cooper, Sir Charles Barkley. So Charles, great to speak with you. What do you think of Cooper and company through two periods here so far?
Well, they're playing fantastic. I got to say a couple things. Number one, Joe Harris. Freaking awesome. Your hair is awesome. You're a good looking man too. You like the Canadian Tom Brady to me.
Gosh. Well, that's maybe the biggest compliment I've ever received from a big man. So Charles, thank you again.
No, thank you for having me. And I was sitting around the house today and I called a commissioner. I said, hey, can I get two tickets tonight? He says, are you coming down? I said, if you get me two tickets, I'm coming down.
Okay, you called Gary Bettman today.
I did. I got his cell. You don't have
What's
it.
What's Gary's number?
Oh, it's on the commish.
Got it.
It's great. On the commish, but I want to thank him for having me.
Yeah, that almost was costly there, not knowing he's coming out. Here's Pat Maroon to the net.
Had a great chance on a follow-up. Now a blast by Chernak. Rebound goal! Anthony Cirelli as the mask came off of Darcy Kuemper. This shot catches Kuemper in the mask.
Goaltender loses his mask. It's usually a whistle unless there's an immediate scoring chance. Great judgment by the referee here. There's immediate scoring chance. You can't take away a good goal like that, and the referee's made the right call.
Here's a cross-ice pass. Rantanen put it on, and a rebound goal. Ricochet out in front. Another power play goal.
This puck deflects off of the skate of MacKinnon as he gets spun around going to the net. A break for Colorado, and it's in the net.
Over it goes for Helm. He drinks and scores. It's a fourth line goal.
A tip by Sturm. Oh, I think this goes off the leg of Cogliano.
Well, it looked like it did. He reacted as if he got a piece of it. Stopping breakaway. Now Taves. That glanced off the post. With 1 point each, nobody has more than two. Kucherov rang it off the pipe. But Nichushkin has it out in front. Sounded like another crossbar struck by Colorado.
Lightning get a change, but now they're going to be caught. Here comes Kadri shooting.
It's in.
And it's in, or is it? Where is it?
Colorado thinks this is in. I think it is in.
No!
Yeah!
Let's go!
I was sure.
How did that not go in?
It did. It did go in.
It did?
It did.
He scores! Nazem Kadri! Yeah. The Kadri man can! I didn't see it, but they did!
He has MacKinnon. Nate MacKinnon put it through Vasilevskiy, but why?
He pulls Vasilevskiy, and you're going to see this puck go right through his legs and out the other side.
Makar, that one full, Vasilevskiy, and a goal on the rebound! Nichushkin has tied the game. He couldn't handle the shot. It bounced off him, and Nichushkin has tied the game.
Vasilevskiy can't get a handle on this long shot from Makar. Kind of an odd shot that flutters to the net.
Get an assist to that, and now Makar shooting, rebound, score!
It hits the skate of Eric Chernak and slides through Andrei Vasilevskiy. A horrible break.
Here comes some line changes. And here comes MacKinnon.
Okay, guys, this is too many men on the ice on Colorado. Corey Perry calls this penalty. He's standing right beside me. He was screaming. I don't know if he's got a career in being a linesman later on, but he's got this one right.
This is one of my favorite moments, Chris. In 1988, yep. Wayne Gretzky. Oh, there's a little bit of a tumble. It's fumble by Nicholas Aubé-Coupel, and he may hear about that for the rest of his career. Yeah, and he won't care because he's right in the middle of it.
Defenseman number 6, Eric Johnson. Defenseman number 4, Bowen Byram. Defenseman number 6, Eric Johnson. Wingers number 16, Nicholas Aubé-Coupel. And number 18, Alex Newhook. Defenseman number 49, Samuel Girard. Winger number 96, Mikko Rantanen.
I'm gonna say sorry that I lost my ability to speak any English after the parade. It was a tough parade for me and Lecky, and like I said, I can't really speak any English now, so I'm just gonna try to talk to Lecky the rest of the night. So love you guys, love you everybody.